Ola baba bambula baba Ola baba bambula baba Om Namah Shivaya Shukar Mahadeva Ola baba Om Namah Shivaya Shukar Mahadeva Ola baba Om Namah Shivaya Shukar Mahadeva Ola baba
Namaste, Sitaram. A pleasant good morning. Welcome to Rudraya. I'm your host, Nisha Sharma, and Rudraya is being brought to you with kind compliments of Maha Rudradev Mandir. And of course, the Mandir is located at 850 Tapscott Road, Unit 34 in Scarborough, with Tapscott and McNichol being our closest intersection. So I hope you had a wonderful Christmas. And of course, this week we're getting into New Year's on Friday, and we're saying goodbye to this year, 2020. And of course, it has been the most challenging year for all of us all over the world. And of course, getting into the 2021, we do hope that 2021 ends much better than this year 2020 is ending. So without further ado, we'll get straight into our pravachan with our spiritual leader, Pandit Ravi Sharma. Enjoy.
तुम हमारे हो रहोगे ओ मेरे प्रियतम तुम्हें चोर सुन नंद दुलारे कोई न द्वारे जाए पुकारो और न कोई सहारो अब तो आके वहां पकड़ लो ओ मेरे प्रियतम तुम हमारे ते प्रभु जी तुम हमारे हो प्रियतम तेरे कारण सब जग चोरा तुम संग तुरा प्यारे एक बार प्रभु बस देख तो तू मेरा ये मेरा प्यारे साची प्रीत तेरे दिखा दो ओ मेरे प्रियतम तुम हमारे ते प्रभु जी हम तुम्हारे हो तुम हमारे हो रहोगे ओ मेरे प्रियतम तुम हमारे ते प्रभु जी तुम हमारे हो
In today's society, we've been told of the power of prayer. What constitutes a prayer? Does a prayer always have to have a purpose? A prayer is centered on a self-conscious and self-judging person relating to an altar. The mode employed by the person praying is never the same. It differs from person to person. Even for a given person, it differs time to time. Prayer also can be a simple mental or oral chant, or strict, elaborate ritual. Now, prayer can be three different forms of karma, action and prayer, physical, kaika, oral, vachik, and mental, manas. Performing a ritual is a physical form of prayer. Singing the praises of the Lord through the medium of bhajans, through the mediums of kirtan, is an oral form of prayer. While chanting a mantra, Om Shambhu Mahesha Karunamaya Shula Pane Stano Girish Girijesha Mahesha Shambhu Bhutesha Bhit Abhaya Sudana Mamanatam Sansar Dukha Hana Jagadisha Rakshaha. So while chanting mantra like these, silently or loud, is but a mental form of prayer. Prayer should always have a purpose, just as how any action that we do commit to, you pray because you want something, is it not? Without an object of desire, there is no prayer. You may want something specific, or you may want clarity of the mind, antakarana shuddhi. You may also pray towards the Lord to be pleased with your prayer because you want to be in His good books. You want Him to glance and may His favorable glance be bestowed upon us. He seems to cast His blessings on others all the time. You may think, why shouldn't the Lord cast His favorable glance ever so often along my way? But when we put ourselves in the equation, something happens. Either He seems to blink His eyes and turn away from us at times, or rather we believe that Paramatma closes His eyes altogether in favor of us. Further, it looks as though you cannot pray for another person. Do you believe that when we pray for another person, they benefit?
Yeah, go cool it, go make it.
My dear viewers, I hope you've enjoyed this morning's Pravachan. And of course, this is our last Pravachan for this year, 2020. As we say goodbye to the year 2020 and we say welcome next week, Saturday, to 2021. And of course, today we're celebrating a special birthday. A family member of Maharajadev Mandir, Rajendra Ramnarayan, is celebrating his birthday for this holiday season. So Rajendra, on behalf of Maharajadev Mandir and the crew at Rudraya, we want to wish you Lord Shiva's blessings for health and happiness and all of life's best treasures. So this is going out to all of us right from your here, your family at Maharajadev Mandir. And of course, we'll get straight into our health segment with our own Dr. Sachin Ramkisoon.
Sitaram, and welcome to Health Corner. I am Dr. Sachin Ramkisoon, and today we start a two-part series discussing how our religion and culture is a key factor in our medical care. Our culture and religion are at the core of our very being, and so many of our beliefs and actions come from this. This means that our culture may also affect our medical care, which is something many of us may be surprised to hear. In our diverse population in Canada, the healthcare system has to be aware of the various cultural and religious beliefs that exist. From a medical standpoint, this diversity means that there are many considerations to take into account when offering or receiving medical treatment. These may actually include the role of family members, the role of key decision makers, and the family hierarchy, the role of the larger community, religious beliefs and its impact on diet, the origin and meaning of illness, and the type of treatment that we tend to accept. Views on maintaining health and wellness, or views on death and dying, or views on Western, alternative, and traditional medicine, gender roles and relationships between family members, and our views on sexuality, fertility, and childbirth. Today, we will focus on just a few of these factors and how our cultural background can affect our medical care. We will start with the structure of the family unit. Culturally, the family unit is at the core of Hindu life. Families are closely knit together, often large, and often want to be involved in the decision-making process. This means that key decisions often have to be discussed with the entire family and not just the individual patient. If this is your wish as a patient, then express this to your healthcare provider that all members of the family be included in the decision-making process. Alternatively, having a large family unit that has traditionally been involved in each other's decision-making process can sometimes be an issue. Some patients do not want their family members knowing their health issues or treatments, even if the extended family may be there with them at the hospital. If this is your wish, then do not hesitate in telling your healthcare provider what your wishes are. Legally, from a medical standpoint, information shared between a physician and a patient is confidential. It cannot be shared with others, even a spouse, child, or other family members. If you want information to be shared with others, you have to specifically let your healthcare provider know this. Next is the role of our larger community. We all tend to rely on our local community for support, especially when it comes to health concerns and medical treatment. This is especially true in the Hindu community, where many may actually find that the opinion of the spiritual leader, elder members, or even close community friends may be useful for guidance and support. This can be useful since there is benefit in discussing stressful situations or reaching out to others about their own experiences. In Canada, we often suffer in silence and isolation instead of reaching out to others in our community. This community support may be very useful in getting us through tough times. Next week, we will discuss how our culture and religion may affect our diet in healthcare, the doctor-patient relationship, and views on death and dying. Thank you for joining with me on Health Corner, and I look forward to speaking with you again next week on Rudraya.
Viewers, we've come to the corporate segment, and I'd like to introduce you to the host for your corporate segment, Kamalji from Lotus Funeral Home.
Sitaram and Namaste. My name is Kamal Bardwaj, and I'm the owner of Lotus Funeral and Cremation Center in Toronto and Kitchener Funeral Homes and Crematorium in Kitchener. I'm also a licensed funeral director. I'd like to talk a few moments about the latest changes the government has applied to the funeral industry when it comes to attendance in particular. So at the moment, the many regions of Toronto and Peel, York, etc., are under a lockdown, which is a gray zone. Now, with funerals, families can still have a funeral and have attendance, but it's a limit to 10 people at a time, which means that you can have a rotation of people coming in and a rotation of people going out. However, the government wants 15 minutes in between the rotation of people for us, the staff, to clean the building. In other words, what we do is we sanitize all the chairs that we use, we sanitize door handles, we clean the washroom, sanitize that as well, and all public spaces. So it does take time to do all that. So as a group leaves the funeral and we clean everything, then we'll invite the next group to come in. Now, these groups are prearranged through a list. What happens is when we meet with a family to make funeral arrangements, we will give them a list based on their times that they're having the funeral. So if they're having a funeral, for example, from 3 in the afternoon to 5 in the afternoon, we'll give them a list that has every 30 minutes, if that's the way we're going to do it, is every 30 minutes, they'll have 10 people listed on that, and they'll be taking people out, and the next group will be coming in based on the list that's been provided to us. So again, the government says that's very important for having these lists for the attendance. However, also the service itself is being live streamed through Zoom. So you can still watch at the comfort at your home, or even if you're in your vehicle, you can watch Zoom on your device that you're using and watch it in live stream and listening to all the speeches and if there's budgets being played, things like that. So those are things that we are now doing. Also, we've been doing for quite some time, but those are things that are being done to accommodate for those who cannot attend. For those that are traveling from out of country, there are ways for people to now attend as well. There's an online application. On this online application, if people like, for example, from New York want to come to Toronto, in advance, before they arrive, we complete the application. We help the family complete it. They get a test result showing a negative COVID test result. We give them supporting documentation, like a proof of death certificate, to show that they're coming to attend a funeral. And once they do the application, they'll get the approval from the government. That allows them to leave their isolation. So when they arrive to Toronto from New York, for example, and they stay at wherever they're staying, they're allowed to leave that place they're staying to attend the funeral, even if it's before the 14 days. So even if they arrive on a Friday, for example, the next day is Saturday, they can attend the funeral specifically because the application was approved. So those are things the government also has done to help families who are coming from abroad to attend a funeral. Thank you very much. And at Lotus Funeral and Cremation Center and at Kitchener Home and Crematorium, we operate 7 days a week and 24 hours a day. Our crematorium is located in our building, so we never have to leave our building in cold or bad weather for a cremation. Our crematorium space can have a large group of people to attend the witnessing of the cremation as well. For Hindu families, we can provide all the puja items, including fresh leaves and a havan kund. We have large halls that can accommodate large seating to smaller ones. We are centrally located for families in the west and for families in the east. For more information, please contact me from the telephone number on the screen. Thank you for watching and see you next week on Rudraya. Sitaram.
Life is beautiful. But death is inevitable. I realized this when my dad passed away. So much pain, and amidst all this, the worry of arranging a funeral. Thankfully, in all this, Kamal stood by me. From the viewing to the cremation, he arranged it all at one location. Once someone is gone, they don't come back. But Lotus Funeral Home knows how to give them a respectable farewell.
Lotus Funeral Home. Life must
My dear viewers, we've come to the end of another segment of Rudraya, and of course, this is your last segment for the year 2020. And as I mentioned during the program today, we'd like to send special birthday greetings to Rajinder Ramnarayan, a member of our Maharajadif family. And of course, it's coming also from your lovely wife, Dolly, and your daughter, Vidya. So Lord Shiva's blessings for health and happiness always. And I would like to thank our kind sponsors at Maharajadif Mandir, as well as our executive producer for making Rudra possible. And I look forward to seeing you for the new year right here on Rudraya. And as we say goodbye to 2020, please remember that never let the sadness of your past and the fear of your future ruin the happiness of your present. So I look forward to seeing you next year right here on Rudraya as we celebrate New Year 2021 next year. And of course, today we say goodbye to year 2020. So for now, have a blessed week. Stay safe, stay healthy, enjoy your New Year's Day on Friday, and wish you Lord Shiva's blessings always. Namaste. It's your birthday, so let me party. Let's gather to cut the cake. Cheers to your life, let's celebrate. Happy birthday to you, another great year for you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Sukriti Shambhata Nadi Mala Vibhoti Manjula Mangala Mora Prasuti Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Jai Rama Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Janamana Manjurama Janamana Manjumukurama Lahara Kiye tilaka guna gana bas karani Je Ram Shri Ram Jai Jai Rama Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Rama Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Rama